the transmission is going through. Wait. Eric, if you can hear me, please listen carefully. Our future depends on you securing your APIs. There is a cyber war coming and your APIs are the target. I'm sending you a list of 10 vulnerabilities that you need to secure first. And it's important that you do this now because they've already found the vulnerability and we don't know how much time we have left.
I'm Brenton House, and you are watching API Cybersecurity 101. APIs are everywhere, and API security has never been more important than it is right now. API abuses have risen in the past few years, and it is difficult to go even a week without reading about another API that has been attacked. By securing your APIs using API security solutions and API management best practices, you can mitigate attacks and protect your organization, your customers, your data, and your reputation. If you saw the previous episodes of API Cybersecurity 101, then you know a properly configured API gateway is the core to your API security strategy. So, I have a question for you today. How secure is your API management strategy? There's a reason that Software AG is the leader of leaders in the API management space. Take a look in the show notes below to learn more about how Software AG can partner with you to securely manage your APIs and integrations. Well, today we are talking about the OWASP Top 10 list for API security, one of the most popular lists of API security vulnerabilities out there. If you are just getting into the series or you are new to APIs, let me quickly explain what an API is. API is an acronym that stands for Application Programming Interface. Basically, it is non-human systems or applications that talk to each other in an agreed-upon way. Most often, when people are talking about APIs, they're referring to web APIs, which include things like REST, GraphQL, gRPC, SOAP, and others. So, why is everyone talking about APIs now? Well, the introduction of smartphones and other smart devices has caused an exponential growth in the adoption of APIs, and pretty much every single mobile application, smart device, and website uses APIs. So what is API security? The simple answer is that it's about applying and managing security for your APIs. But as I often say, there's nothing simple about API security. This then leads us to OWASP. So what is OWASP? You may or may not have heard of OWASP before, but it is the Open Web Application Security Project. They are an international nonprofit organization dedicated to web application security. What they are most known for is their reoccurring top 10 list of web vulnerabilities, but they also have a top 10 list covering API security. This list was created in 2019, but it is absolutely relevant and applicable today. So let's jump into it. The first on the list is broken object-level authorization. An example of this would be if an attacker were to substitute the ID in an API call with a different one and is able to get access to data that they should not have access to. Say I had a banking API with my account number at the end. Now, what if I were to replace my account number with someone else's account number? This example may seem far-fetched, but you would be surprised. There's a reason that we have them on this list, and it's because there are APIs that are published with these vulnerabilities. All your resources need to run authorization checks before providing access to a client. An API gateway provides the highly granular level of access control necessary to prevent these issues. You will then be able to control access to resources and methods via scope level policy definitions. Next, we have broken user authentication. APIs that are not using secure authentication are at risk of attackers compromising their system using this exploit. There are numerous authentication schemes that allow you to mitigate the risk to your APIs, including but not limited to OAuth, JWT, SAML, Kerberos, OpenID, Basic Auth, Client Certificates, and more. Excessive data exposure is next on the list. Often, an API will publish more data than what you see displayed through the user interface. It is important to sanitize and filter the data that is being exposed through the API, as this can be accessed and viewed using other methods. Take advantage of your API management system to apply data transformation and data masking features to your APIs. Next, we have lack of resources and rate limiting. Without proper limits on access to resources, an attacker can easily overload your API system. Using features like rate limiting, throttling, and other threat protection policies in your API gateway, you can block denial of service attacks, limit large payloads, stop SQL injection, monitor traffic, and stop other attacks that can affect your APIs and other resources. Next, watch out for broken function level authorization. Similar to broken object level authorization, API endpoints that are used for admin purposes need to use secure authorization policies. An attacker may be able to guess an admin endpoint, and an API cannot rely on a client implementing proper authorization. Securing admin endpoints and resources will shield your API resources from this exploit. Next is a vulnerability due to mass assignment. In an effort to transform and bind data from clients, sometimes a mass assignment vulnerability can creep in. This happens when an API allows data from the client to save properties that the user shouldn't have permissions to update. A best practice for avoiding this is to only use whitelist and not blacklist. Ensuring that your API gateway is configured with a policy enforcement to specifically define the properties that can be updated is just one way to protect your API and data from this security threat. Security misconfiguration is another vulnerability that you need to watch out for. Security misconfiguration is probably one of the most common issues leading to security exploits. While human error is tough to protect against, an API gateway can shift some of that responsibility to shared and global security policy definitions, which can be applied to large collections of APIs, thus limiting your security issues. Next is injection. API attacks can come in the form of malicious code that a client might try and trick an API into executing. APIs often have to interpret unknown data, and a vulnerability can be exploited if the API blindly executes that code. It's important to never blindly trust an API client, even with internal consumers. By defining data types and schemas and validating all requests through threat protection policies defined in your API gateway, you can prevent SQL injections and other injection attacks. Next up is improper asset management. Production APIs are not the only surface area that you need to be protecting. There are several types of APIs that you might be running that could provide an attacker access to valuable data on your system. Some of them you're more familiar with. You have your public APIs or your external APIs. You have internal APIs, partner APIs, third-party APIs, and composite APIs. Some of the other types of APIs that you might not be as familiar with or think about are your beta APIs or the non-production versions of your APIs, such as alpha, beta, testing, staging, release candidate, and others. Then you have your shadow APIs, and those are internal or public APIs that you've created, but try to keep them off the radar. Zombie APIs, APIs that work and are in use, but haven't been updated and are probably using outdated security. And Frankenstein APIs, unofficial APIs that are hacked together to scrape systems that don't provide real APIs. All APIs need to be managed and secured to ensure that your data, your customers, and your company are protected. Last but not least, we have insufficient logging and monitoring. Most breach studies show that the time to detect a breach is over 200 days, and is typically detected by external parties rather than by internal processes or through monitoring. Without proper logging and monitoring, attacks on your APIs and data can go unnoticed. Be sure you are implementing traffic monitoring policies via your API gateway that can monitor runtime performance conditions, enforce limits on your service invocations, and send you alerts when conditions are violated. Also, ensure that your logs are sanitized of sensitive information and are formatted in a way that other logging and security tools can consume and process them if necessary. This has been a quick run through of the OWASP top 10 list for API security. But each of these items is critical enough to deserve its own episode, so stay tuned for more details about content covering the vulnerabilities on this list. You are watching API Cybersecurity 101, the show that equips technical and business users to level up their API security. Feel free to add any comments or questions that you might have about API security in the comments section below. I'm Brenton House, and again, thank you for watching. Check out the show notes below for links and bonus content. And as always, subscribe to this channel to stay up to date with the ever-changing world of APIs, cybersecurity, and digital transformation.